Welcome, everybody. We'll get started in just a couple minutes here. Painted on the sky. Glad you could be with us. The moonshine, teardrop in my eye. Country roads, take me home to the place. Okay, I think we are just about ready to get started here. Awesome. So in just a second, Skylar is going to share her screen, but welcome to SSP's Tsaile weeks 3 through 5 orientation. It's so lovely to see your faces. Talked to so many of you for many years and not seen any faces in connection with your names. I am Veronica Russell, SSP's Director of Engagement and Impact. And with us today, helping to lead this orientation is our co-directors, as well as a few community members that are going to be joining in quickly, and members of our medical advisory council. So Skylar and Jess, would you go ahead and introduce yourselves?
Hi, I'm Skylar. My name is Skylar. I use she/her pronouns. I will be the alumni connection this summer, helping the staff get ready, and will not actually be there when you all arrive. But I'm helping the staff. And I'm really sorry, Heather. I just saw your reaction. I've served on staff for a number of years now, both in Walker River, Nevada, and then for 4 summers and then Zoom summer in Tsaile. So really excited for you all to be able to experience this summer. And I'll hand it over to Jess. And Jess might not be able to turn on her sound right now. So Jess is, you're gonna be your co-director. Oh, she's unmuted, there we go. No, I'll do it for her. She's a senior at Cal Poly. She'll be graduating in the next 2 weeks. She will be there, and she's been on staff in Spokane as a construction coordinator, and then 2 summers on Zoom, and is really excited to meet you all and lead you. And I don't know that we have any community members on here yet, some of them will be joining us, and I'll hand it back over to Veronica for any more introduction.
Yeah, real quickly, I just want to invite, I believe from our medical advisory council, we have Kelly Schreiber here. So Kelly, give everybody a wave. She'll share a little bit more about herself and her role on the council later on. And then I believe we have one board member here, Brenda Scalzi. So Brenda, give us a wave as well. Thanks for being here. And then my colleague, Adam, if you could give a wave as well. Adam will be here for tech support today. So if you have any Zoom issues, you can direct message Adam and he can help you out. So I think Jess is able to verbally join us possibly soon. So Jess.
Yes. Can you hear me now?
Yes, I can.
Awesome. That Cal Poly Wi-Fi is not the best, but we're back now. So hi, everyone. I know Skylar introduced me, but my name is Jess, and I will be your site director this summer. I'm a senior at Cal Poly, graduating a week from Saturday, and this will be my 4th summer on staff with SSP, and I've always wanted to work in Tsaile, so I'm really excited to be with you all there this summer.
Awesome. Yeah, we have a great set of folks leading today. So let's just jump right in and get started here. So we're going to have some pretty pictures in just a moment for you to follow along with what we have to share. All right. So today we have quite a few things that we are just going to jump through here. It's going to be pretty fast paced. So thanks for your patience and your willingness to, you know, be flexible and have a good time. That's what the SSP spirit is all about. So we've introduced our staff. We're going to go over a few norms that are part of the SSP community and expectations for volunteers and staff. And today I want to highlight a few resources that we're going to use throughout this orientation, which include breakout rooms. We'll be doing an interactive quiz at the end. It has some fun music. If you've ever played Kahoot, that is the, you know, the platform we'll use. And we will also have a parking lot document. If you're unfamiliar with that term, it just means a place where you can park your questions, and we will get back to them and try to answer in live time as soon as possible. So Adam and I will be monitoring that throughout the call. So that link that Adam just dropped in the chat is where you can access that document. And there's a few FAQ questions down below, so that you can see questions that people have already asked that might be similar. We'd also love to see your faces as much as possible. So if you can keep your cameras on, we would love that, but we understand if you can't. It'll just be a fun way to get to know others who will be on site with us. So the next thing that I'm going to ask you to do is to rename yourselves. This will essentially help us make breakouts later on in the session. So you'll see that Skylar, myself, Adam have renamed ourselves in a specific format that Adam is also going to drop in the chat to help you out. The first thing in your name should be the number of week you're participating. So if you're going week 4, which starts July 24th, that you'll say 4, and then the next piece will be your role this summer. So if you are a youth, anyone under 18, you'll say Y. You could say A for an adult, F for family, or anyone who's here as a guest to SSP, whether that's from the board or our community or medical advisory council, you can also say S. So it should be number, that specific letter, and then your first name. And Adam can help you out to rename yourselves if needed. So this is going to eventually help us put you into rooms with other people who will be attending the same week as you. So feel free to chat us if you need any assistance with that. The next thing we're going to get into is our community norms and expectations. One of the things that I think makes SSP such a great space is that we prioritize safe environments for all participants, whether they are youth or adults or community members. So we ask that you treat all members of the SSP community with respect, people that you know, people that you don't know. Everyone is deserving of that. So we have some more details on what that looks like in action in some of these links, which Adam is going to be dropping into the chat, including our safe community policy, which you might have heard of as our safe sanctuary policy. This just has updated language in the last few years. We also, you know, ask that as much as possible, folks be engaged in all aspects of the week. It's important to model that, especially at weeks that are youth-centric, although we know some sessions are for intergenerational participants. So we'll get to that in the next slide. We also have definitely some spelled out pieces of our COVID safety policies and how to prepare with some of these expectations in those links that you see at the bottom there. So specifically for adult volunteers, the things that we expect from adults are going to be on the next slide here. And that includes, like I said previously, good modeling for engaging in all activities as much as possible. So this third point down here, We value youth development, but the service experience is also for adults. So we invite all of you who are adults here to be open to trying something new, even if you're there as a leader for youth. And for our intergenerational sessions, we do value adult development. So if you are attending as part of, you know, just a young adult group or something like that, and you're not comfortable leading youth, that's something that you can communicate to our site staff in advance, and we kind of adjust project plans accordingly. It also means if you're on the work site with a youth, be sure to, you know, give them a whack at demo or whatever project is going on so that they have a chance to get their hands in the dirty work and learn some new skills, because we want to prioritize folks being able to do that. Safety also looks like practicing the rule of threes at SSP. This is a way to protect both minors and adults. So our rule is that no one youth and no one adult should be alone together. So basically to practice the rule of threes, this just means that when you are in kind of enclosed private spaces, make sure you have at least two youth and one adult, or one youth and two adults, to meet our safety requirements. The exclusion to that is a family member. For example, if a parent child is attending on their own. We also background screen and require mandated reporter training for all adults 18 and older to attend SSP. This is an updated, a little bit more stringent requirement this year because of an assembly bill passed by the state of California, where we are headquartered. So obviously you'll all be serving in Tsaile, not in California, but there will be Californian participants. So just as a safety precaution, we ask all adults to go through the mandated reporter training. And you can feel free to ask us more questions about that later in this call or offline. So I think that covers most of the expectations that I wanted to chat about. So I'm going to pass it on over to Jess to talk about our summer theme.
Hi again. Are we good on audio now? It's a little bit quieter where I'm at. Okay, awesome. So every year SSP loves to have a theme for our summer. It just kind of roots a lot of our conversations throughout the week and gives us a lot to think about. So this year, our theme is titled In This Place. You can see the design on the slide by a fellow staff member, Ashley Rios. So In This Place emphasizes physical presence after we've all been apart for two whole years. Particularly with our partner communities this summer, Smith River, California, Tsaile on the Navajo Nation, and San Diego and Imperial Beach. We're just going to be talking a lot about the history of the places and people that we're with, the places that we're serving, and the people within those communities. Many faith traditions are rooted in particular places or communities, showing that a lot of our sense of meaning is also rooted in this place. So we look forward to exploring that theme with you all this summer. And without further ado, we will talk a little bit more about Tsaile specifically. So we will be on the Navajo Nation this summer. And in these next couple slides, we're just gonna talk about what arriving to our site, what our accommodations look like, the community partners we will be working with, and how to prepare and what your expectations should look like. So POV, you arrive at Diné College. So Diné College is where we will be staying this summer. There are two entrances. They're both those beautiful signs you see on the picture, the left-hand side. So either way you come, you will see one of those signs and that will be your signal to turn. The college is built in a circle, which is really unique. So either way you'll enter, you'll drive around in the circle until you see the structures pictured on the right-hand side of this slide. They are called hogans, and those are the dorms of the college. You'll pull into a parking lot where our staff will be there to welcome you, rain or shine, the Sunday you arrive. Also, on that picture on the left-hand side, you can see the road is being repaved right by the college, which is very exciting. hadn't been repaved since the 60s. So a little bit more about Diné College. It's the first tribally controlled community college in the United States. So it opened in 1968. Although it originally opened as a community college, today it offers both 2-year and 4-year degrees. And we've partnered with this college for over a decade, I think over 15 years. So we feel very privileged that we get to be back, even with some of the reservations, stricter COVID guidelines. So like I mentioned in the previous slide, we will be staying in the dorm Hogans. Each of your cohorts will have 2 dorm rooms assigned to them, and maybe more dependent on your group size. So the way the Hogans work is they have 2 bedrooms with 1 bathroom in between. So 1 bathroom for every 2 bedrooms. You'll be able to use those spaces just with your cohort, so you don't have to worry about masking in the shower, things like that. Apart from the Hogans, the college has a basketball court and a sand volleyball court. You can see the basketball court pictured on the slide bottom center. We utilize this space a lot for things like song time and evening program after our construction work days. So we love to hang out there, and the sand volleyball court is new this summer. So really excited for that. This year, we will be eating most of our dinners at the school's cafeteria, which is pictured in that upper right-hand corner. It has a picnic area right outside where we will eat when weather permits. But in Tsaile, there are some monsoons. You can see that the tables inside are distanced as well. So we will keep COVID concerns at the forefront of our mind when eating as well. And then last thing is, this year we will be respecting the college's COVID guidelines, just like we are respecting our own as well. For all of you, we will be creating name badges that just verify that, 1, you're part of SSP, and 2, that you're vaccinated, so that the campus security on the college campus knows you're there and you're meant to be there.
Thank you, Jess. So I'm going to speak a little bit to the community partners that we'll be interacting with this summer. So Jess spoke a little bit about the college, and the college is located right at a T-intersection coming in from Tsaile, and then to the north is the Lukachukai chapter, and to the south is the Tsaile, Wheatfields, and Black Rock chapter. This summer, we'll continue our partnership with both chapter houses. And for those of you that are unfamiliar with the language of chapter house, it's very similar to like a local government building. It houses chapter meetings where decisions are made for the local community, as well as community service opportunities where people get their hay, and also where just things are communicated from the larger Navajo Nation to individual communities. Some of you may remember our partnership with them in previous summers, especially in 2019, where we were able to do the Just Move It running 5K walk with both chapters and then on the campus. And right now there's no plans to do that, but we've been in conversation with both chapter house leadership, and there are plenty of opportunities for us to be doing things with them this summer. In the Tsaile Wheatfields chapter, there is also the Senior Center, which is located next to the gas station right near the college. And right now, due to some construction happening on the Lukachukai Senior Center, both chapters' elders are meeting at the Senior Center to have meals, to have fellowship together, and also to just have a place to be during the day. We'll also be continuing our partnership with the Water Users Association. They're going through some changes in leadership and the ways in which they are, or like their daily operations. But in these bottom 2 photos here, you can see some of the things that you can expect to do with them this summer. We'll be helping local farmers, especially elders, be able to get irrigation to their fields, which is this lower left-hand photo, moving these big pipes. And then in the lower right-hand corner, this particular person is helping set up fence. And some of the things that we'll be doing this summer is helping repair fence from where cattle and other livestock has knocked over fence line to get into fields. So come prepared with high visibility shirts, and we'll have some work gloves, but make sure you do have a set of work gloves, even if you think you might be on a project that doesn't need it. The other partner that we work with very closely is Dene College Campus. Jess spoke a little bit to our housing arrangement there, where we work closely with the student housing department to be able to stay in the dorms. But we'll also be able to hear from the Dene Policy Institute, which is located on the college campus. Michael Parrish will be with us each week, and his summer policy interns, who are doing a wide variety of work across the nation, will spend time with us each week. So we're very grateful to listen to and hear both the concerns of the local communities and also the ways in which they are actively making change in their community. Some of you who have been to Tsaile might remember that right across the way from our parking lot is the sometimes animals and gardens, and it's land, that is the land grant office. And so through our partnership with the water users this summer, we'll also be working a little more closely with the land grant office to do some projects there and to just hear what they're doing with some of the things that have come through during and post COVID. And then of course there's the post office on campus. So for all of you family members that are on here or people who want to send ahead things for your youth to open, letters, et cetera, we do have a post office and our staff will be checking that every day to be able to pick that up. And on our website, you can find the address for the general delivery. I am going to open up the participants list and just see if we have any of our community members here tonight.
I don't think we do, Skylar, but I added the link to last week's orientation in the chat for any folks that want to hear directly from Silver Nez Perry, who we have worked with. He was able to join us for last week's orientation.
Great. And also for those of you who may be interested in hearing more from Silver, he has graciously spent some time with our staff, but also opened it to anyone who's coming this summer to share a bit about Navajo culture and what life is like there today. And those have been recorded, and there is another one coming up this Sunday at 4 p.m. So check social media for that link, and we can keep moving on. So just preparations and expectations. Please check your packing list. These are very important, especially if you are the team lead for your group. You'll notice that I have not one, but two photos of our 5-gallon orange jugs. Hydration is extremely important at this site. Many of you will be coming from much lower elevations and then coming up to about 7,200 feet. So on your drive, even if it means a few more bathroom breaks, please, please, please hydrate. While you're there, we will remind everyone that hydration is key, and that we will constantly have them both in the Hogan and then bringing them to site each day. There is a time change to mountain time. So if you are coming from Arizona or from the West Coast, you will be moving ahead an hour. From those of you coming further east, just remember to be checking when you enter the Navajo Nation to be changing to mountain time. Some expectations for your time at site. Weather is a constant, fun thing that we get to have, and our motto is that we are very flexible. We don't make plans, we make hopes. So as you can see in this lower photo, in the span of about 5 minutes, we've got monsoon weather, lightning, and like a beautiful clear sunset. And this is very typical, especially in the summers. We've heard from the local community that although the last two summers there has been very little rain, and that monsoon season has also been pushed back by several weeks, we really don't know what to expect this summer. So just be prepared that plans each day might change a bit, and that the plan at the beginning of the day to go to site might change as weather comes in and you return to site. Our staff will always be trying to find things for you to do and be creative in the ways in which we are gathering together. Especially this summer, we'll be keeping in mind our COVID protocols. The amount of time that we have to spend inside is not as fun, but we will be making sure that we have extra ample space and activities to do that promote our both COVID guidelines and also continuation of that SSP spirit. Again, at site, hydrate, hydrate, hydrate. This goes back to the packing list. We are going to ask everybody to bring their own water bottles this summer so that they have them both for being on site and for being in our hogans on the college campus. The last thing that you can expect is great times. So it's been, you know, two really long years of being apart. And I know the staff is very excited. And for those of you who've experienced SSP before, you know how great this week can be. And so we're really excited to share that with you again. We're going to give you guys a quick stretch break. I don't want you to go too far from your computers, but you have, if you have water, if you need to like stretch your arms, grab something and come back, I'll give you about 10 to 15 seconds and then kind of verbally call you back in. And then we'll move on to our next part of this orientation, which is our medical advisory council.
All right, thanks Skylar and Jess for sharing about site-specific things. While you're gathering your stretching of limbs, just a quick reminder that if you do have any questions coming up, you can always drop those in the parking lot. So Adam has dropped that in the chat. And I don't see that we have any questions currently, so just know that we're keeping an eye on it. And we'll be answering as questions come up. So if you start to make your way back from your stretching and getting your biological needs taken care of, I want to transition into our COVID safety portion of the orientation. You'll see here that Kelly Schreiber, who is with us today, is our lovely little thumbnail at this of this video. So we will take a few minutes to watch this video, which is compiled from our Medical Advisory Council members, and then have a space for Q&A. So Kelly, would you like to introduce yourself now and share more about your experience with SSP and in the medical world?
Sure. So my name is Kelly, and I'm a current board member with SSP. I've served for several years as an adult volunteer, bringing kids from my former church, and I'm currently a medical student, which is how I got roped into being on the medical advisory committee. So enjoy our absolutely Hollywood grade production here, giving you all the answers to every one of your COVID questions.
Love it. Thank you, Kelly. I failed to mention, if we can pause real fast, that Kelly is also a board member. So, and I think that we also have a second council member here with us, Sophia, who joined a little bit later. So Sophia, would you introduce yourself?
Yeah. Hey, everyone. My name is Sophia. I am used to be a participant at SSP. I've been to Tsaile, it's beautiful. And then I started on staff at Chiloquin, which was wonderful. And I am a physician assistant in ICU and helped to develop some of these COVID policies.
Awesome. Thanks, Sophia. Wide range of experience relevant to how to keep people safe at SSP. So we're grateful for our council. So without further ado, let's get into the video.
Hello. In this video, we'll talk about some things we've learned about COVID-19 and how to keep every member of the SSP community safe as we return to overnight programs. These safety plans were developed by SSP's Medical Advisory Council, five healthcare professionals familiar with SSP's programs. Each safety measure is an act of service to our partner communities. Thank you.
Hello all, my name is Katie Strong. I attended SSP as a youth for 5 summers as a volunteer and also served on staff and maybe met some of you during the years of 2017, 2018, and 2019.
Hi, my name is Kelly Schreiber. I'm a board member with SSP.
Hi everyone, my name is Sophia Lariva. I was on summer staff in Chilliwack.
Hello, I'm Dave Herbert. I'm a physician specializing in infectious diseases. And I've been helping SSP develop ways to keep our volunteers, staff, and community safe in this time of COVID.
Here's a brief overview of what we will cover in this video. Vaccination, testing, and quality masking, being outside and volunteer cohorts, hygiene, as well as our response plan to positive cases. We'll talk about all of these things in more detail, but thank you for joining us.
I know that most of us feel that we're just done with COVID, but it is clear that COVID is not done with us, as infections are once again increasing. One of the most important ways we can protect one another from COVID-19 is through vaccination. While we know that vaccination does not completely prevent COVID, it markedly decreases the risk of getting infected, as well as the risk of passing along an infection if you are infected. And of course, it dramatically reduces the chance of serious illness if you do become infected. Since the SSP program inherently includes communal living and interaction among people from many different regions, it is important for us to add as many layers of protection as possible to prevent the spread of this virus. And vaccines are our first line of defense. This especially protects SSP's partner communities, which are historically medically underserved and therefore at higher risk if an outbreak occurs. So to make the SSP service trip as safe as possible, we require full vaccination, including boosters as eligible for everyone. This means being fully vaccinated with 2 doses of the Moderna or Pfizer vaccines, or 1 dose of the Johnson & Johnson vaccination, plus boosters as eligible. Since our program is voluntary, we are unable to consider any exceptions since they would place people at increased risk. Thank you and have a great trip.
This summer, we're gonna mask up anytime we're in enclosed indoor spaces with people who aren't in our cohort. That means places like kitchens, shared bathrooms, and any indoor community spaces are all gonna be masked areas. We also know that really wearing high quality masks makes a big difference. Those are masks like an N95, or like a KN94-95 mask. These have extra layers and filters that really help stop the spread of coronavirus and help protect us and the community that we're serving. We also know that if you have a mask, that's not enough. You gotta wear it the right way. So we're also gonna make sure everyone is covering their nose fully and has a really good seal with their mask around their face. Masks are not going to be required when you're in outdoor spaces where you can maintain physical distance with other people, or when spending time indoors with only your cohort. So that's in spaces like wherever you're sleeping and your vehicles. SSP is going to provide 2 masks for every volunteer for every day as needed. But if you have a favorite brand of mask that you want to bring with you, you're welcome to do so, so long as it's as good or better than the N95s or KN95s that SSP is requiring.
Another way we can prevent the spread of the virus is thorough testing. This is why we require all volunteers to provide a proof of a negative COVID test upon arrival. Both rapid at-home testing and PCR lab testing work. Be mindful of your exposure between testing and arrival. If you feel sick, please stay home, even if you have a negative test. When you arrive, the first thing staff will do is verify each person's negative results with the group leader. Staff will also test everyone 48 hours after arrival and as needed throughout the week. SSP will provide and coordinate all midweek testing, so don't worry about bringing tests with you.
This year, we'll do everything outside as much as possible. All home repair projects will be outdoors to protect the safety of residents and volunteers. We will also eat meals, sing, and do evening program outdoors. See our packing list to make sure you're bringing the right gear and clothes for the weather. Volunteers also have the option to tent camp outdoors at any SSP site.
Cohorting is an important precaution to decrease the impact on the broader community in the event of a positive case. Cohorting will mean that volunteers will stay in their same arrival group, vehicle, work team, and sleeping space. Cabins, tents, and dorm rooms will be shared by cohort. These will have improved ventilation. We will also cohort when eating, when distancing is not possible, and stagger shower times by cohort. In the event someone tests positive, it will be unlikely that they will have spread the virus to other cohorts. Now, we understand this is an adjustment to how we normally mix groups at SSP, so we thank you for your flexibility.
Of course, being safety conscious also means having good hygiene. SSP settings may be rustic, but we have tools to help volunteers and staff do this well. SSP is increasing the availability of hand sanitizer and hand washing stations and uses gloves when serving food. We will also continue our practices of using soapy water to clean, followed by a bleach solution to sanitize the surfaces. Opportunities to serve, which cohorts rotate through, involving daily cleaning and sanitization of the kitchen, tables, restrooms, and high-touch surfaces.
We know that in spite of our best efforts, there is always the possibility of a positive COVID case at SSP programs. In the event someone becomes symptomatic or tests positive, that person will isolate, and others who meet high-risk exposure criteria will also be tested and increase mask usage within their cohort to prevent additional spread. Those who test positive have two options: one, isolating on site for the duration of the week, or two, departing from site to travel home. Especially for those with symptoms, SSP does encourage departure from site. If you test positive within 48 hours of departing SSP site, please notify us so that we can identify other potentially exposed volunteers. All this to say, you have your support from this Medical Advisory Council, and all of these measures have been developed with the intention of decreasing risk to keep everyone safe.
Now that we've gone over SSP's safety plan, we hope you feel more prepared to serve with us. You can read more details in SSP's written materials and can always reach out directly with any questions. The Medical Advisory Council will also make themselves available as we navigate a new way of being together in person. Thank you for prioritizing safety. We can't wait to serve with you.
All right, thanks everyone. I wanna open it up to questions for Kelly and Sophia, because obviously this is the first time we are returning to in-person overnight work since the start of the pandemic. So do you folks have any questions, or Kelly or Sophia have anything you'd like to add?
I guess while we're waiting for questions, the only thing I wanted to add is that, you know, we thought really long and hard about ways to keep everybody safe. So I hope that you all feel like this was intentionally thought out as much as possible, and that we have plans for all of us to be available as problems arise throughout the summer. Hopefully they won't, but that we're all here to support us doing this in person as safely as possible.
I have a quick question about the testing. So we're supposed to test within 24 hours of getting to SSP?
The rule is within 72 hours of arrival. However, we're encouraging that test as close as possible to your departure, just to limit the number of exposures people might have between testing and actually arriving at SSP. So for example, if I were bringing kids from my church, I might actually just test everyone at the church parking lot before we depart so that we don't have any exposure time. But I believe the rule is 72 hours, correct, Veronica?
Yes, so this means 72 hours before arriving, no more than that. Kind of best practice will be to, you know, if you would like to facilitate this all together with your group, say, you know, bring a test to a church parking lot or something the morning of, or have the church provide those. There's lots of ways to get, you know, free tests, and all tests together morning of would be a great way to do that, to ensure that you're getting the most recent results. So does that help clarify that question, Christy?
Yes. And the second part of the question is, how do we show you that we had negative tests? Do we need to bring the test with us to show you that it came negative, or?
A good question. There are instructions in the written handout that accompanies this video for that with some photo examples. So I think if Adam has dropped that link in the chat to the handout. So that includes basically something that's a timestamp of confirming, you know, you could hold up, for example, your phone with the date and time on it next to the test results, and ideally write the youth's name in Sharpie, for example, on the test or something so that you can distinguish who the test belongs to and when it was done. I saw there was another question in the chat on how often there will be COVID testing during the week. So we will retest everyone 48 hours after arriving on site. And then as needed, if symptoms arise or exposures are identified. Anything else to add, Kelly or Sophia, or follow-ups to that question?
It might be helpful to say that the testing, like, you don't have to bring your second test to site. There will be tests available in Tsaile.
Yeah, SSP is coordinating all the midweek testing.
Yeah, so to just confirm, the midweek testing is a public health preemptive measure to catch any asymptomatic folks who may have COVID. And then anyone with symptoms or with a high-risk exposure, let's say someone in your group starts having those said symptoms and you were, you know, around them. And a high-risk exposure is classified as greater than 15 minutes unmasked in an enclosed space with somebody. And having had several COVID exposures myself recently, you know, it's very scary and you're like, oh my gosh, I don't want to have COVID. But at the same time, with this kind of fear, but this knowledge now that we have of how COVID spreads, we are going to be keeping to those criteria that we know statistically and research has shown dictates a higher likelihood of actually contracting the virus.
Thanks for that context, Sophia. Any other questions coming up for folks? All right, well, you can feel free to add questions to the chat or to the parking lot if you have more. So with that, I think we'll transition right along here.
Great, so we're gonna do some breakouts. Adam in the background has been putting people into groups. So in just a moment, you'll be sent to a breakout room. This is a great time to get to know people that will be there during the week that you are. In this group, we'd love for everyone to introduce yourself quickly with your name, your pronouns, where you're from, and any SSP experience you have. And then we'd also like everyone to answer, what is your favorite place in the world? Once everyone has done that, if we still have a little bit of time, we'd love for one or a few of you to share one thing you're excited for this summer, either at SSP or something else this summer that is exciting for you. So with that, you will also get a 60-second notification that you'll be brought back. Please speak up all the way to that time, use up that 60 seconds, and then you will be brought back at the end of those 60 seconds. So we'll have a few minutes to chat and get to know one another. So I will let Adam send us to our places.
Yeah, so we're usually...
Welcome back, folks.
So we're usually...
Sorry, Silver, I think there's a bit of a delay. While you all were in breakouts, we had Silver Nez Perry join us. So Silver, would you like to introduce yourself to the group and share briefly about what folks who either have visited the Navajo Nation before or are going to be new to visiting should know about the area?
Yes, sir. Hi, everybody. Silver Nez Perry, not often at a cheap name, Sla. Tashi Dene, a bushes chain. That is how we introduce ourselves amongst my people. And it's basically our clan. And our clan is roughly like our bloodline. So we are represented by four of them. First one being our mother's clan, and then born for our father's clan, and then our maternal grandfather's clan, and then our paternal grandfather's clan. So that way, when we travel across the reservation and we introduce ourselves, we basically could run into another clan member that could be our family. So that's what keeps our society together. It's the glue to our Navajo society, is our clan, our affiliation. So when you do come out to the reservation, you might run into elders who still introduced themselves. If I'm here this summer, I will definitely explain more about it, about the clan system. And just want to welcome all of you that will be coming out this coming fall. It's been a few years. And a lot of the elders keep asking for you guys, wondering when you guys are going to come back out and do some more work. So they do enjoy seeing you guys come out this way. So so far I've told them that you guys will be out this way. So some of them are excited. The employees that work at the local senior centers are excited that you guys will be coming out. And some of the employees at the college will be excited to see you guys. So just want to say welcome. Hope you guys will have a great time. If I don't make it this summer, I will definitely still be doing Zoom. And we'll just have to figure out a good time slot just so I can talk to you guys while you're here. So we'll figure something out if I don't make it. But if I do make it, you'll see me almost every day hanging out over there at the college with you guys, enjoying lunch or dinner or whatever. So that's all I have. We do have a Zoom scheduled for this coming Sunday. It's going to be 2:00 Mountain Daylight Time, 2 p.m. And I was going to have it scheduled. I did have one scheduled on Sunday, but it was just Megan and I. So we're going to do another one this coming Sunday. If you guys want to Zoom in, we'll go ahead and send you that link. And I'm going to be talking about the role of male and female in Navajo society from birth all the way into old age. And then talk about Navajo wedding. And then in future talks, I'm going to be talking about the kinship, the clan affiliation, and how that is integrated in our society. And go back into talking about basically Navajo culture, Navajo history, Navajo language. So we'll send you out that link, and feel free to join us this coming Sunday at 2:00 Mountain Daylight Time. And I look forward to seeing you guys. That's all I have.
So much good stuff. Thank you, Silver. We dropped the Zoom link for that Sunday event in the chat, and it's also available on SSP's online calendar on our website. So thank you for being here. I think with that, we will transition to our little Kahoot time, and we're a few minutes behind where we would wanna be. So just know that we'll go a couple minutes over, and if you have to leave, that's okay. We're recording the whole session, so you can catch the end of it later on. So Skylar and Jess, we ready to Kahoot it up?
Sweet. So as Jess brings up her screen share, we're going to do a Kahoot. Some of you who've been on online SSP have used these as fun things throughout the summer, but this is just going to be a way to remember some of the important points from tonight and to have some takeaways. I will verbally acknowledge for those of you who were taking notes when I was speaking earlier, I realized I'm on East Coast time. So it is at 1 p.m. California time, Silver Talk, not 4 p.m., 1 p.m. And that will be reflected in your calendar note, but I realized while I was with our small group. So, okay. Jess, are you able to also speak right now?
I am. The class next to me just got out. They'll quiet down in a minute. But for now, on the screen in front of me, you will be able to go to that website, kahoot.it. I would recommend on your phone if you have it available. And then you're gonna type in the game pin on the screen and your name as well. So I'll give you all a few minutes to get in the quiz before we start. I'll give it like 30 more seconds. We love the Kahoot music at SSP. And then, so you know, in case you've never played a Kahoot before, the questions will pop up and then each answer will correspond to a certain color. So instead of pressing the actual correct answer on your device, you'll be pressing whatever color or shape corresponds to the right answer. And without further ado, I think we'll get started. Oh, one more person snuck in. Two more. Okay, good. I never want to leave anyone behind. So first question. We'll have multiple right answers, so you can press more than one right answer. What norms does SSP expect from all its volunteers? Only be nice to people from your church, treat all members of the SSP community with respect, talk over our staff when they're giving instructions, and do your best to be an engaged participant. Great job, everyone. Yeah, two right answers there. We like to treat each other with respect and be engaged. Next is a true or false. I need to know how to use tools before coming to SSP. Oh, answering quickly on this one. Good job, everyone. That one is false. So the Monday morning you arrive, the staff will be giving you a safety presentation where we will teach you how to use all the tools and equipment necessary for the projects you'll be completing. Next, this one also has multiple right answers. What can you find in the prep packet? Veronica mentioned this pretty briefly earlier. There are some hints for you on the screen, but go ahead and pick whichever answers you think are correct. All of the above. So if you haven't had a chance to take a look at the prep packet, you can find some frequently asked questions in there, as well as packing lists. If you've never been, we have typical daily and weekly schedules as well, and then all of our information on COVID safety. What is SSP's summer 2022 theme? There's kind of a hint in the picture, but the title's not included. But that is our t-shirt design this year. Awesome, in this place. But if you were tricked, it's probably because all the other answers were themes from previous years. Another multi-select, who are SSP's partner communities this summer? So what sites is SSP running? Smith River, Tsaile, and San Diego. So no Spokane this year, but we do love it there. What should you pack for the work site? Might get some clues from the picture on the screen. Awesome, so some silly wrong answers in there, but highly, highly recommend work gloves. SSP provides them for people who do not have them, but closed-toed shoes are required on the work site because we are dealing with some pretty intense equipment and we don't want anything falling on your feet, things like that. So we're halfway through and Shelby's staying on top of that scoreboard. Where will we be staying in Tsaile? A local church, camping, Dene College, oh, great job. That was super fast. So Dene College this year. Another one related to Tsaile. Which of the following are community partners in Tsaile? And there are multiple right answers. Another tricky, all of the above. The one in the picture on the screen was the Water Users Association, but we will be working with both of these chapter houses as well as the Policy Institute at the college and the Water Users Association. Heather taken over on the scoreboard. When should you take your first COVID test for SSP? As close to leaving as possible, right after arriving, a week in advance, or not at all? Awesome, great job. As close to leaving as possible. So a week would be a little too far in advance. We do say no more than 72 hours prior. When do you wear your mask at SSP? And we have some models on the screen during a weekend of service in Sacramento, I believe. Awesome, great job again. The construction site one's a little tricky, which is why I put it on there. So if you're outside at your construction site and you're just with your cohort, you do not actually need to mask as you are working. However, if your homeowner is home and comes out for any reason to just say hi or wants to hang out or watch what you're doing, or if there's anyone volunteering from the community alongside you, that's when we would ask you to wear your mask at the construction site. Other than that, just indoor activities, except for sleeping, eating, and personal hygiene, and anytime we're interacting with the community. Why do we wear masks at SSP? protecting not only ourselves, but everyone in our community. And last but not least, a little bit of a fun one. This summer, you will, multiple right answers. And pictured on the slide is Canyon de Chelly, not far from Tsaile, and we will be going there during our week together. All of the above again, we'll build community together, we'll have fun, and apart from that, we'll learn how to use power tools and learn about Indigenous culture and life. And with that, we'll just take a look at our podium. We have Jen, sorry if you put the emoji, I don't know who that was. And on top, we have Shelby. Great job, everyone, but thank you for playing.
So fun. Thanks all for being part of that. We love a good quiz. Leslie, thanks for being the box. Shout out to Leslie. So this is the last set of things that we have for you. Just a reminder that if you have ongoing questions, you can add them to the parking lot or contact us directly. This email, mac@sierraserviceproject.org, goes to our Medical Advisory Council. So you are welcome to email that link for COVID safety and process questions. And info@sierraserviceproject.org goes to a few of us at the SSP office. And if needed, we can forward along to the site directors accordingly. So we just invite you to, you know, stay in touch. Don't be strangers leading up to the summer. We know that this is taking place right now, the day before we have volunteer forms due and final payments. So I'm happy to stay on and answer any of those questions as they're coming up, if you're a liaison or trying to get your forms done. But with that, thanks for being here, and you're welcome to sign off. But if you have questions, we'll stay on for a few minutes longer, and lovely to meet you and see your faces. We'll see you on site. Thanks all.
Thanks everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, how many participants will be at week 4 in Tsaile? That is a great question. It changes every day, I feel like. Adam, would you mind pulling that up quickly?
Sure, give me just a minute.
Okay, thank you. While he's pulling that up, any other questions coming up? Sally, I think Megan was able to connect with you earlier about some questions. Okay. Great.
As of this very moment, we have a very intimate week 4 in Tsaile, 8 people.
We are trying to specifically get some local members of the community to be volunteers that week. So there's a few homeowners that have reached out to us and said they're interested in being more part of the experience for the week. So that is a week that we're focusing on for local participation. Okay, any other questions coming up?
Thanks a lot for the program. It was very interesting. I'm heading out.
Okay, thanks, Sally.
Bye.
Nice to see you.
Thank you, Sally.